This is a quick derivation of a technique for finding the arc length of a curve if I have a function f of x defined. So I could just put in, I guess, some limits of integration on this. Maybe I just want to find the length of this curve between x equals a and x equals b. And I'm going to take a physical integration type approach to this, so kind of a physicist's perspective. The idea is, provided that I take a short enough little interval, a little chunk of arc is going to be a pretty straight line. And of course, we're thinking about this in some kind of limit where it becomes literally true. And I'm going to call that a little contribution to the arc length, ds. Let's see, I'll switch to gray for this. And ds can be broken down into its x and y components. And that's dx and dy, these two infinitesimal quantities, and those two little line segments are perpendicular to each other. So then, given that in the limit this becomes perfectly true, I'm allowed to use the Pythagorean theorem. And I will say the ds squared is dx squared plus dy squared. And that means a little contribution to the arc length, ds, is given by the square root of dx squared plus dy squared. And all I have to do to find the total arc length from the starting point to the finishing point is add up all of these ds's. So we're still not quite in a usable form. What I need to get is only, I need to have just one of these differential quantities tacked onto some expression in order to integrate. So what I'm going to do is factor a dx out of both terms under here. So I'll go like this. Okay, and pulling out the dx, so the square root of dx squared is just dx. I'm left with, in the square root, a 1 plus dy dx, in other words, the derivative of the function, with a dx outside of it. All right, so now I have, if I maybe just write one more step, just switching to prime notation to make something really clear. This is entirely a function of x on the right-hand side. And then I have an infinitesimal dx attached to it. This thing is ready to integrate. So to get the total arc length, I use a capital S for that usually. The total arc length is the sum of all the contributions to the arc length, so the integral of all the ds's, which gives me the integral as x goes from a to b. Square root 1 plus f prime of x dx. So I am also going to record several examples of computing arc lengths, but something you should know about this. Oops. Forgive me for forgetting a exponent. Something you should know about these integrals is that this is just so ugly, the square root of 1 plus the derivative of a thing squared, that you almost never end up with an integral that can be done symbolically. So for most reasonable problems, you're going to end up numerically approximating the arc length.